Bill Hammond here with the Elder Law Question of the Week. You know, I recently had a family come in and talk about people who are really trying to do right by their mother. I had three kids. Mom has Alzheimer's, and the kids were making sure that she could stay at home as long as possible. Made sense, except things were now coming to the point where it really wasn't perhaps exactly safe. Mom was playing with the stove a little bit, and the kids were there at the time, and so they could take care of things. And they actually had things set up so that at all times one of the kids was going to be there. Okay, that's great, but then they admitted to me they were all worn out. And as they were going through the long goodbye with their mother, they went back to a promise they had made with her, to her actually, several years ago. They told her back then, "Mom, we'll never put you in a nursing home." Well, that was all well and good at the time, but now they were literally ruining their own health trying to keep a promise that really should never have been made. So we had a discussion about what I would call substituted judgment, and I asked them, if you could go back maybe 10 years ago, before your mom was showing any symptoms, and if you had the discussion with your mother and said, "Hey mom, 10 years from now, you're going to get to the point where you barely know us. We are trying to keep you at home, but we're ruining our own health. Do you think it would be okay if we ever get to that point where we go ahead and place you in a care center?" And as we discussed that, all of the kids agreed, yeah, if they could have had that conversation, mom would have been the first to say, "Yeah, you guys need to take care of yourself so that you can also become my care advocate." So the point is, you have to think in terms sometimes of substituting the judgment of someone who's able to make good decisions and not be tied into promises that should never have been made in the first place. That's the way caregivers stay healthy, by going through these processes and then making sure that your loved one gets the care that he or she needs. When you do that, then everybody can be taken care of, not only the one who needs care, but also the ones who are caregiving. As always, if you have any questions or situations you'd like us to deal with, please feel free to contact me, and I look forward to talking with you next week at the Elder Law Question of the Week. Now, have a great day. Thank you.